Thank you, Chaitanya team for having me here. The presentation I'm going to make is on hyperrefractory spots and vascular diseases versus age-related macular degeneration. So hyperrefractory spots, first described by Koskas and a decade ago, are characterized by well-circumscribed lesions seen on SD-OCT. They're sized 20 to 40 microns in diameter, and they have typically reflectivity more than or equal to the RPE band. Most of the literature suggests that a single line scan or a volume scan spanning the fovea, but the line scan crossing the fovea and the hyperreflective dots are measured within the 1500 microns from the central fovea. The lesions which are less than 20 microns are discarded as noise, and more than 50 microns, possibly because of the hard exudates, are discarded. And they're graded as few, moderate, or many based on the number. Various vascular diseases like diabetic macular edema, CRVO, and degenerative diseases like PCV and age-related macular degeneration, in addition to retinal dystrophies, have been described in literature associated with hyperreflective spots or hyperreflective foci. So in vascular diseases, typically the lesion in diabetic macular edema starts around the macroaneurysm, and they get scattered eventually in all the retinal layers. The origin of these lesions are supposedly from the lipoprotein extravasation from the breakdown of the inner retinal barrier. Later on, it was believed that it is a surrogate marker of microglial activation, and this contain lipid-laden macrophages, which are scavenging macromolecules. In age-related macular degeneration, similarly, the lesions are typically located in the outer retinal layers, in contrast to the vascular diseases. And in age-related macular degeneration, which is the dry type, it is next to the drusen and the geographic atrophy, and around the fluid accumulation in neovascular AMD. Origin, again, it was believed to be migration of the RPE cells, which was later discarded. And the theory more commonly believed now is that these are lipovision and like molecules which are engulfed by the phagocytes. So why are hyperreflective foci such in such interest? Because it is believed that they are indicator of increased retinal inflammation, which later on causes transformation of microglial cells into the active state. And this increases, the microglial cells increase in number, and then they translocate throughout the retina. And these microglial cells then change in their morphology and cause aggregation, which are being detected on SD-OCT as hyperreflective dots. In vascular diseases, number of hyperreflective spots have been shown to be higher in patients who are anti-VEGF non-responders. And similarly, when these patients were treated with dexamethasone implant, they did not respond. They responded better when there was a higher number of hyperreflective spots. In neovascular AMD, the presence of hyperreflective spots in the foveal neurosensory retina at baseline was associated with poor visual acuity, and their resolution improved the final visual acuity. In eyes with higher number of hyperreflective spots at the baseline had greater reduction in the central foveal thickness. And also, if there was a greater reduction in the hyperreflective spots from, say, many to moderate and moderate to few, it had a greater therapeutic response. The resolution of the hyperreflective spots in the inner retinal layers correlated with a greater anatomical improvement, and large amounts of hyperreflective spots may indicate a more chronic disease. So it was seen that there was a very little functional gain in spite of a good structural restoration when the hyperreflective spots were multiple. So there are certain common features between the hyperreflective spots in vascular and AMD diseases. Larger amounts of hyperreflective spots imply that there is a more severe blood retinal barrier breakdown, and this is generally associated with poor prognosis. The resolution of these spots with treatment correlates positively with favorable outcome. There are contrasting features as to the location of these hyperreflective spots and the origin, and the literature is still not on consensus of what they are. So to conclude, I'm no authority on this hyperreflectivity spots, but I believe that in retinal vascular diseases, when I see hyperreflectivity spots, it lowers my threshold to move to intravitreal corticosteroids. And similarly, in neovascular AMD, I would follow a more aggressive approach with anti-VEGF therapy and may switch to a longer-acting anti-VEGF with shorter extensions with treat and extend regimen after complete drying and consider concomitant intravitreal corticosteroid as a last resort. Thank you so much.